The Diaries of Agent Silent Death perks the Freedom Chronicles back up just a little bit after the disappointing start with Gunslinger Joe. Wolfenstein 2 is a game renowned for hard-hitting, pulse-pounding action, but the tempo set in the Diaries of Agent Silent Death tries to slow down things into a hitman espionage thriller, with mixed results. Voiced by Claudia Black of Stargate fame, you play as Jessica Valiant, better known as Agent Silent Death. But instead of shoulder charging your way through Nazis, now you have to quietly skulk around through grates and knife them in the noggin. This time around, the three-part structure for the Freedom Chronicles episodes suits Agent Silent Death because she has three different targets to pursue. Now, each target is responsible, in part, for the death of her beloved Jack. And so Jessica will visit California, Hollywood, and even the moon in order to set things right. And that's the immediate difference between Joe and Jessica. Location variety is so much more obvious and welcome this time around. Agent Silent Death feels like a clear three-part story which you can get invested in, helped by the silky tones of Black as she weaves a tortured narrative on the road to redemption. Now, whereas Gunslinger Joe felt like a throwaway add-on, I'd argue that the concept for the Freedom Chronicles was actually built around Jessica Valiant. Bethesda and Machine Gun Games' thinking behind the season pass becomes more and more clear the more you play Agent Silent Death. And even though I'm still not completely convinced by this season pass, I definitely enjoyed Agent Silent Death much more because of that. I even spent more time playing this as sections are trickier and Jessica isn't as bulletproof as either BJ or Gunslinger Joe, which does ensure you play the game a little bit differently than before. The aim is clearly to be as covert as possible, and so you need to be more aware of enemy patrols, the crawling spaces that are around, and the vantage points of your enemies. That's something Wolfenstein 2 didn't really pat you on the back for. The problem is, you can tell that Wolfenstein 2 was not built or designed to be a game that focuses on stealth, and so it's very difficult to ghost an entire level without being spotted. Jessica has abilities which make her harder to spot than most. Her footsteps and her jumping has been silenced, she has quick draw abilities, and enemies freeze whenever they spot her. But enemies still seem to have bat-like hearing and eyes like a hawk all the same, no matter how careful you are being. At some point, you're just going to have to concede that the action is probably going to break down into an all-out warfare, and due to the sheer size of reinforcements that come and swarm you, you will quickly get overwhelmed. Of course, Silent Death also suffers from the same problem as Gunslinger Joe in that it is an exceptionally short piece of content, though it's certainly less noticeable due to the difficulty spike and the narrative. It's also incredibly expensive individually, so you'll almost certainly want to buy it as part of the season pass, though understandably, that's a tough sell. There are more collectibles this time out, and the use of a silencer as a weapon of choice is certainly more of an appealing proposition than machine guns blazing for challenge missions. But Agent Silent Death is, at once, a briefly entertaining diversion from your backlog, but ultimately, another forgettable piece of content. The Diaries of Agent Silent Death shows a glimpse of how stealth could work in Wolfenstein to exciting effect, but the foundations of such an action-orientated game don't provide the sufficient backing for that will and desire. So to summarize, on the pro side, there's a good narrative structure and is very well voice acted. There are enjoyable takedowns and hitman possibilities for each of your targets, and it is more challenging and varied than Gunslinger Joe. On the cons, stealth doesn't naturally work in the new Colossus, and numbers can get quite overwhelming and really overrun you very quickly. It's still very pricey individually and very short, and it's unlikely you're going to get too much out of the game as before. But we have decided to give Wolfenstein 2 The Freedom Chronicles, The Diaries of Agent Silent Death, the second piece of DLC in this season pass, a 6.5 out of 10. And we tested this on a PC. Thanks very much for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. If you haven't already seen our Gunslinger Joe review, that is available on the channel and is linked below. And we are, of course, going to be reviewing the deeds of Captain Wilkins to close out this season pass to see how that fares in The Freedom Chronicles. But so far, the DLC has been a little bit hit and miss for us. Let us know what you think, though, in the comment section below. You may think completely differently, and we'd love to hear from you. And of course, we've got tons of other DLC reviews, news, trailers, and previews on the channel, so be sure to check those out. Thanks for watching. See you next time.